Ghetto Garage, Wildcard Customs, Raleigh Northern Boy, Paint Pimp, Tummy Shoe. It's Thursday. Mood indicator light, it's always the same. I'm not really, anyway, it's 20 after 3. We're gonna do the good things. The hood is done. The glue, we did that. So the get more ventilation. I don't know what that noise was. Ice is falling. Cause it is sunny out. That's a good thing. Temperature is gonna be this weekend 31 degrees the low, which is a good thing. What am I grateful for? I don't know. I'm not in a good mood, but I'll explain why, and I'm gonna work through it. Okay, on your mark, get set, go. First thing is my Hutchinson Airboard, the mini. There's my big one, and I could use that, but I started sanding on this. Okay, and then this thing started locking up. Okay, well, you see all the pieces. Yeah, it's all apart. Okay, so I should have called Hutchinson first. Anyway, I got their number, and these gaskets, they go on the end, you know, they're only $3.46, or you can buy the whole gasket kit for like $15. That's fine. I talked to a guy there, he's really nice. They couldn't tell me what shipping would be because they had to go to the next building. Okay, wow. Anyway, the reason I called him is because this top plate, actually the top plate is soaking in lacquer thinner. The top plate would be that right there. Okay, it sits on here and there's no gasket. So I cleaned all that off. It looked like contact cement. I wasn't sure. So that's one reason I called him. It is contact cement. Or he says you can use Permatex. Well, Permatex I think is really good, but I know contact cement, I don't want no air leak. Basically the reason I said I should have talked to him first, because he's a nice older gentleman, is that he says usually why it quits working is nothing internally, it's always an air leak. Well, that is true because this handle right there, what this slides inside it, and then this is metal, that's aluminum. Somebody cross-threaded it. Lovely. So if I tighten this up more, this would not allow the trigger to go all the way down. So I went and tried to buy another bolt, or Allen or whatever. I wanted aluminum. I didn't want it steel because I can't thread that down in there. You can't see it, but it's a narrow shaft. And there's an air outlet, right? You can see it a little bit right there, the little hole. So you can only thread it so far. And it's a... ...10mm by 1. And then they make by 1.25, 1.5. Jeez, oh Pete, man. But anyway, I went down to a specialty store. What is the place called? Alice Supply. Anyway, I always do the shuck and jive, what I call a shuck and jive. You can't do that at Lowe's, Menards, or Walmart because they're too big. But I always wanted one of these boards. You know, just when I was working on my, when I work on my chopper or whatever, you just want to know what thread it is without guessing. Anyway, I just shuck and jive and I said, you know, asked him how business was doing, because I go into periodically and I try to keep a small business open. He said it's kind of slow. And I said, I always wanted one of these, and I think this is $45. I said, I'll give it to you for, I'll take it for 40. He goes, yeah. Anyway, you know, I buy a little nut and bolt and things and it adds up real quick. But anyway, that was a good deal. And then he sees my hands are all cracked. And he says, this is the answer to the world. And it's orderless, you know, and he wanted $6.95 for it. And he said, I said, is it an old deals? Because I already bought that and didn't anticipate buying that. He goes, how about six? I said, how about five out the door and I'll leave you alone. And he said, okay. Actually, I've used it once. And what I like is, I didn't know it was made in America. Can't beat that. But you know what, this stuff, you put it on, it's greasy, and then it dries, and it almost feels like wax on your finger, but not really. It's kind of grippy. And I put it on, and I put my gloves on. I like this stuff so far. I think this is, because I always try to wear gloves, and you could tell I don't wear gloves a lot, because, you know, I start with gloves, and I don't end up with gloves. Anyway, my point is, I bought this Hutchinson for $120 off the internet, off eBay. It was used. When I got it, it was full of plaster. You know what happens to plaster? They use it for drywall instead of body work. Plaster, when it gets wet, it turns rock hard. So I had tore it apart then, not this far. And I called the guy after a day, and I said, you know what? It's not worth my time. You know, I just sent it back. And he goes, how can he make it right? So he said he'd give me $25 back. Okay, fine. Because I was going to send it back. These things cost like $260 new. So now I got, after giving me $25 back, I got what, 75, today 75, 80, 90, I got $90 tied up in it. It's still cheap. Okay, I talked to the guy on the phone in Hutchinson. He said a whole kit is like $14, and they charge $25 to rebuild it. Okay, this is my point. I shouldn't have went this far. But you know what? At least I know, because this was all full of glue too. At least I know how it goes together. Maybe I can help somebody what not do, what to do. My point is, if I can't get this back together, which I say I can, then maybe Tommy Shoes should close Ghetto Garage down, because I feel I am king of cobble. And I shouldn't say the word cobble, but you know what? I can put things back together. And he said he's going to send me a timing sheet, because if you don't get these right on the sides, the time to be off. Well, I'm not stupid. You see that? See that purple mark and that purple mark on the gear? Maybe I got it upside down. That purple mark on the gear? See, I mark stuff with a paint pen before I take it apart, just in case. Because I tore this one apart. And see how I did the timing marks? What I call timing marks? The green and the red? Don't never use the same marker, because you might not use those marks. This one used to stop. I fixed it. I bought that used off eBay for $109. The only reason I know it was $109, because I took the time today and I laminated all the things, because my hands get greasy and I don't want. See right there. That's what I even write down. When I bought, $109 used. New was $264. That was for the Orbital longboard sander. So no, that wouldn't be it. My mistake, that's a straight line sander. The orbital sander is this one. Anyway, my point is, things ain't always smooth. And yeah, I'm getting frustrated, don't get me wrong. But I gotta figure out, is it worth my time to work on it? And the bad thing is with me, if I can't get it to work, I will be mad at me and disappointed with me, because I feel if somebody put it together, I'm pretty slick that I can, if somebody can build it, I can tear it apart and put it back together. But you see how it got carried away, little pieces all over? This is not the way to do it. The way to do it is take those and mark them and put them in a Ziploc baking and tell yourself where they go. See, now, I want these guests only $345, but shipping's out of control. So, this guy says it's probably not best to try to make these, because that goes around a piston. Okay, you know what? It's a cereal box. If I could buy these right now, I'd buy them. But I'm not going to get price gouges on shipping. It's not going to happen. So, I'm going to do it myself. And if I can't get together, I'm going to put it in the box, swallow my pride, and say, you know what? At least I tried. At least I tore it apart. At least I know I shouldn't have tore it apart. Am I mad at myself for that? No. You know, it's a learning curve. Sometimes I jump the gun. I really believe now, after it was all said and done, it was because air was leaking out of there. Because it wasn't going full throttle like it should. Anyway, I got what, $90 tied up into it, $25 for labor. How much would shipping be there? How much for parts? I don't know where I'm at. And I'm irritated. Do I need to use this right now? No. But this is not really flat. This is concave, the tailgate. Can I use that? Yeah. But it's just, I bought this to use. And my point is, you know, in the past I would take this and say, put it on the shelf and say, you know, I'll work on it later. No. No. Because you know what happens when you say, I'll do it later. Later turns into 2 days, 3 days, and all these parts, you won't know where they go. Do I want to do this right now? No, I don't. I want to work on this. And there's a gentleman on there saying that body men, they have a time schedule to, that's why this happens. You know what? See that right there? You know what? I don't mean to let Todd out. But you know what? They're allowed an X amount of hours, and if they get done ahead of time, they go home, they go on the internet, they go porno, they do whatever they do. No, they're a lot of time to scuff that paint down. That irritates me. You know what? This is wrong. And I've seen a lot of people do it. And somebody come on my channel and say, well, they don't have time to do it because they got to get to the next job. You know what? Bullshit. Because good work today is good work tomorrow. A lie today is a lie tomorrow. Call a spade, that is wrong. That creates a person like me more time, because that's not supposed to chip like that. Somebody flim-flam because you couldn't prove it. Now, I don't mean to get in a rant, but you know what? I've dealt with this one too many times, that crap. And all it does, I've had it where they didn't even scuff it, where you start sanding and the paint rolls. That's just, I don't mean to get pissy, but motherfucker. Don't tell me they don't have time. Yes, they do. Yes, they do. I have time. You know, and if you're going to have a body shop do it, why doesn't the body shop take pictures of the work they're doing? You know, if they can't afford a camera, I'll give them a camera. If I was going to pay someone to do body work, show me you're going to do it right. Do I trust you? I'm sorry, no, I don't. It's guilty until proven innocent, not innocent until proven guilty, because I've been scammed more than once on stuff. Especially when it comes to bodywork, you never know what's there until later. Till later. If a body man can't, if he does good work, he could take a picture right now. Boom, there's a picture. That's what I started with. Right before I laid primer, boom, that's how I feathered it out. Boom, that's where I put high bill primer in. No, I didn't slam Bondo mud all over in a hole. You take a picture of the stuff, and until people like us demand that, they're not gonna do that. Because people, you don't understand, the mass really have control like us. We're the one that's spending the money. I would demand pictures. I'm the one that offered Don, Tattoo Don, pictures when I did his Mustang. Before I even did YouTube. I showed him. Why? That's the work I'm doing. You know, guys that do backyard bodywork like me, it kind of leaves a bad taste in your mouth, but the bad taste in your mouth comes from not the backyard bodymen. It's sometimes the corporate big body shops that are getting insurance money and they're flim-flamming together. And I'm not saying bad things about body shops, but I've seen it done with my brother's vet and stuff. I've seen it done. And then sometimes they hold your car for hostage and they have it so long, and I've been on this rant and I'm just going to stop. Like I said, it's going to... Here's another program I like watching. That 70s show. And here's a song for you. Something to my God, Elijah, a little bit of a career. Say you're black as a bat, the sweeter the juice. I say you're off of the flesh, and you're deep of the roots. Life is good! This is where we say peace and good, be good to everybody.